As English speakers, we rely heavily on word order. We stick to the order of subject, verb, object. The only time we don't mind this rule being broken is in poetry, or when watching Yoda in Star Wars. Rather than placing a noun first in a sentence to make it the subject, Greek will tag that noun to mark it as the subject. Same with the object. If a noun is giving possession, it will be tagged that way. And if it is the indirect object in a sentence, it will be tagged that way too. For now, let's color tag them to indicate these functions. In Greek, these functions relate to what is called the case of a noun. There are four main noun cases in Greek. Nominative indicates the subject. Genitive indicates possession. Dative indicates the indirect object. And accusative indicates the direct object. So, knowing that I have tagged these English words by color, I can mess them up along with the verb, and you'd still understand it because of the color tagging. This is how Greek works. We call it inflection. Here's the verb we'll work with. Greek nouns add morphological tags to the end of nouns to indicate their function in a sentence. Because of these morphological tags, Greek is not as dependent on word order as English. And it will take some getting used to. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. You can find me on the web at ntgreekresources.com, which includes my blog and Twitter feed, and of course numerous resources to help you learn Greek, including apps, songs, videos, software training, and more.